What kind of marketplace are you building? Whether it's about renting, services, products, or something else, order types are your best friend. Hi there, Gautam from Sharetribe here. In this video, we'll be talking about what order types are, how to choose which order types to have, how to create them, and how they are displayed in your marketplace to your users. Let's dive straight in. What are order types exactly? Order types are a feature of Sharetribe Go that determines what kind of transaction takes place between your providers and customers. Is your marketplace about renting something or selling something? Or perhaps your marketplace is about offering services? Or maybe it's for posting announcements? This is where order types come in. In Sharetribe Go, you have a number of setting options to create the order type you need to facilitate the kind of transactions your marketplace is for. You can also have many order types in the same marketplace. But how do you choose your order types? I'll present to you a few questions about the type of transaction you're looking to facilitate. These will help you decide what kind of order type to create. When a customer wants to initiate a transaction, will the transaction have a price? Or will your listings be free? Will the online payment function of your marketplace be used? Do you want your customers to pay on the platform, or will they transact off-platform? Do you want to collect a commission on transactions? This is only possible with online payments. What is the unit of pricing? For apartment rentals, this could be per night. For booking cleaning services, it could be per hour. Essentially, what is sold in your marketplace? And lastly, do you want your providers to be able to determine when a listing is available? With rentals, services, and bookings, your providers may benefit from an availability calendar where they can block off unavailable dates or hours. When you've answered these questions, you're more than halfway to creating your order type already. Your answers tell you which settings to configure, and they in turn define what information providers have to fill when they post a listing. So let's exemplify this with a peer-to-peer car rental marketplace. The answers to the questions could be as follows. Yes, the transactions will have a price. Providers can put up their car for rent when they don't need it themselves and make some extra money. The pricing unit will be per day. Your customers can rent a car for a day trip or a longer journey. You definitely want to use online payments, since you want to offer your users a secure way to make purchases and, of course, collect a commission on the transactions yourself. And yes, you want to use the availability calendar to make it easy for both providers and customers to automatically keep track of whether a car is available or not. Depending on how you answer these questions, the settings of your order type may be completely different. The last step is to create the order type in your admin panel. You'll find the order type settings under Listings. The settings for the car rental order type would look like this. The name and checkout button label indicate that this is indeed an order type for renting cars. Under Pricing and Checkout, adding a price, accepting payments online, and the availability calendar are enabled. And because the availability calendar is used, we have chosen per day as the pricing unit. And now we'll take a look at order types from your user's perspective. To your users, order types are called listing types. In the listing creation view, your providers choose the listing type before they can type in any further details. If you have only one order type, all listings will automatically use that one. Then, switching to a customer's experience all this. In the main listing browse view, you can find a dropdown of listing types to filter by. If you only have one order type, this dropdown will not appear. Okay, we're nearing the end of the video, so let's recap. We learned what order types are, namely the type of transaction that takes place on your marketplace. We talked about how to choose your order types and learned some useful questions that help figure them out. We briefly checked how order types are created in your admin panel. And finally, we looked at how they are displayed to your users. Thank you so much for joining me, and do check out our videos about categories and listing fields as well. See you there!